Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. This video series deals with working on various CGI render passes in Autodesk Smoke. From going through the previous videos, we have prepped up all our CGI elements. We will now combine them together and composite. Let's start off by combining the robot and the football again. Press the Effects Node button to bring up the Connect Effects Node bin. Press B to display the Blend and Comp node. Drag the Blend and Comp node out of the node bin and place it next to the robot and the football node trees. Starting with the football, connect the motion blur result into the first red front input. Now connect the motion blur alpha into the first blue matte input. Next, we'll connect the robot into the Blend and Comp node. Connect the motion blur result into the second red front input. And finally, connect the motion blur alpha into the second blue matte input. Double-click on the Blend and Comp node to bring up its controls and show the result of the selected node. Scrub the positioner to the middle of the time bar. You will see that we now have the robot and the football composited together with their motion blur. Press F4 to toggle the result view and the out matte view to see the alpha. Ensure you return to the result view. For organization's sake, let's rename some of the nodes. Ensure the node is selected and change the name to Robot Football Pass. Move down the schematic and locate the blur node for the background. Select it and rename it to Video Background. Now select the color correct node for the CGI smoke. Rename it to CGI Smoke Fill. And finally, select the Logic Op node for the CGI Smoke's Alpha. Rename it to CGI Smoke Alpha. You take the time to do this so you know what the passes are doing at this point in the node tree. Now locate the main Blend and Comp node that has been combining the CGI smoke with the video background. Click and drag to move the node. This will give it a bit more room in the Connect Effects schematic. We want to layer the passes in a certain way, so I will break the connections for the CGI smoke render passes. Let's start off with the foreground elements. Drag the result output from the robot and football pass into the first red front input of the Blend and Comp node. Next, drag the alpha output and connect it into the first blue matte input. In the result view, you can see the robot and the football over the video background. However, the edges around the robot's feet are still not correct. This is because the fill is pre-multiplied with the alpha in this Blend and Comp node. This is easy to fix. Double-click on the Blend and Comp node to see its controls. Change the pre-multiplication pull-down menu from Keep as is to Divide. This fixes the edges in the semi-transparent areas of the render pass. Now focusing on the Blend and Comp node inputs, the first input of the node is always the top layer. We will now use the second input to insert the CGI smoke under the robot and the football. Drag the result output from the CGI smoke fill into the second red front input of the Blend and Comp node. Next, drag the CGI smoke alpha result output and connect it into the second blue matte input. Since the CGI smoke fill was already unpre-multiplied, it composites correctly with the other CGI elements and the video background. Since we added the smoke around the robot's feet, his color values have changed again. Let's have a look why. In the Blend and Comp node, you have a blend control between the two inputs and another blend control between the inputs and the background. Looking at the inputs blend mode, I can see it is set to additive. Change the mode from add to blend. So with both blend modes set to blend, the composite should look correct. So this is what we have so far. Now that everything is combined together, there are a few tweaks I would like to do. Let's set this Blend and Comp node as our contextual view. Hold the dash keyboard shortcut and click on the node. Hover over the result view and press Ctrl 1 to see the contextual view. It is the same as the result view we have been looking at. Let's tweak a few things. Firstly, we can adjust the brightness of the robot and the football. In the Connect Effect schematic, select the Blend and Comp node for the robot and football render passes. Input 1 controls the football. Set the luminance to 65. This will darken the ball and bring back some of its detail. Input 2 controls the robot. Set its luminance to 50. Now you could have done this with a color correction node before this Blend and Comp node. But since it has these controls, it's quicker to do the adjustments here. The last thing I want to look at is the robot's edges. Go to frame 1 in the time bar. In the context view, the robot's edges are quite hard and could do with a bit of softening. This could be for photorealism or creative taste. Click the Effects Node button to toggle to the Connect Effects Node bin. Press M for the Matte Edge node. Drag out the Matte Edge node and drop it into the connection that controls the alpha of the robot. Softening the alpha's edges will smooth out the robot's curves. Double-click on the Matte Edge node to see its controls. Enable the Blur button. That's a bit too much blurring, so set the width to 1.0. That should be fine. Now, if you were just layering and tweaking your render passes, the Blend and Comp and Logic Op nodes are great just for combining everything together. However, if you want to add additional 3D models, relight the CGI, and many other visually enhancing effects, you would use the Smoke's 3D Compositor. In the next video, we replace the main Blend and Comp node with the Action 3D Compositor. We will use it to combine the CGI render passes, add an additional FBX 3D model, and use some of the lighting effects to complete the composite. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.